Joanne, those, Tracy, is by the end of the year that those ramps from First Avenue up to the high rise for the West Seattle will be open and up and running.
By when?
By the end of the year.
Okay, so they won't be in time for this 9-day viaduct closure.
No, ma'am, they will not be completed for this closure. But the lower, going First Avenue under, coming underneath with Lower Spokane, that'll be completely open, two lanes in each direction to help take some of the congestion off the, from the north-south off the east-west movement there.
Okay, anything else that the city specifically is advising people, particularly from the West Seattle side of town?
Yeah, I think a couple of things. So, Trace, I think a lot of this, it's going to be more of a p.m. peak hour, you know, coming back. And the a.m., if you're coming from West Seattle, you have the 4th Avenue loop ramp, and you can get on the lower bridge coming across and get into the grid system. Now, coming back, we would, in working with the state and our task force, with the county, the state, and the city, that we're trying to keep that lower roadway open through there. We'd ask people to try to adjust their work hours a little bit, maybe leave a little bit earlier before the peak hour or after peak hour, you know, 6:30 or something in that time frame for that week that this closure is going to happen. We're going to be looking at all of our signal timings to make sure the progression of traffic is kind of a north-south progression of traffic in through there, because, you know, we're kind of squeezed north-south-wise for through movements down there, to make sure that that progression is through there. We're going to have all of our ITS. We've invested a lot of money in our ITS system, our dynamic messaging boards. We're going to have those up and running to notify the public. We're going to have our TMC staff, which is our Traffic Management Center at SDOT and the Seattle Municipal Tower, to have real-time information to be able to tweak traffic progressions to try to move that mobility one way or another. As you know, just a little bit of movement one way or another can keep things moving. So we're going to have the TMC additional staffing in there to fine-tune the traffic sequencing through there. So I think we're taking a lot of the right steps, and certainly this is the first step in getting the word out early the viaduct is going to be closed for that week, and to start notifying the public and working with our partners.